Today we are reviewing Boruto episode 53, Himawari's birthday. So seeing as how I've already seen the movie, I knew it was going to happen in this episode and I know it's going to happen in the upcoming episodes. But I was pleasantly surprised with the things that they added. I was hoping they added some things and they delivered. So it looks like we're going to be getting this arc at its max potential, story-wise at least, because they added new things that they had to cut from the movie the first time. So I'm hopefully this is all Kishimoto's input. But even if it's not, the things that we got added were pretty good. And I think we might have seen a character that didn't appear in the movie or in the manga up until this point, and he just might have gotten revealed during this episode. But I'll talk to that when I get to it. So the episode starts with the third Otsutsuki member, and he lands on the moon where Tonari is, and we find out things like how he's a member, or the main branch of the Otsutsuki is still around, and that they've been watching because they knew about what happened when Naruto came to the moon and battled Tonari. And the third member, I'm not sure if we've gotten a name for him yet, or I might have just forgotten it, but he says he's not authorized to kill a clan member, which makes me think he's not part of the main family, which means that the main family sent these guys as underlings. Guys who are at least Hokage or Kage level are underlings. So this is some crazy stuff we're getting right off the bat. And then the third Otsutsuki member, I have no idea what I'm going to call him until we figure out his name. But he freezes or turns Tonari into stone, and says he isn't authorized to kill him, so that means that Tonari's still alive, but he's just turned to stone. And I don't think Naruto's coming back to the moon. So rest in peace, Tonari. So after that, we get straight to the movie stuff with the added filler with Denki, when Naruto's talking about what it takes to be a ninja, and he's like, perseverance, hard work, and good luck. And I'm like, okay, man. Because I remember that scene from the movie. I'm like, couldn't you just come up with something on the fly? But Boruto talks about how he doesn't want to become a chunin. He just needs to become a ninja like Sasuke because he's cool. And then Denki talks about how he's all mysterious and stuff. And if Naruto is still a genin like he said a few episodes ago, then I guess Sasuke is a genin too. And if they're both genin, who's to say a genin can't be legendary? After that, we switch over to Team Shikadai, and he seems really determined to become a chunin after the stuff that happened in that one filler arc with the, what were they called, the Byakuya gang? So it looks like that arc did have a little bit of purpose. But meanwhile, Chocho's only worried about missing out on the springtime of her youth, so I'm like, too much time with Gai Sensei. After that, we get to Katsuki's meeting with Naruto about using ninja tech during the exams. And he says no, well, Naruto says no, and Katsuki just returns to his lab all sad, and Naruto's like, was I too mean to him? And Shikamaru's like, nah, he needs to know. And here's the part I was talking about earlier. So when Katsuki returns to his lab, we see someone behind him, and that person must be the person that put the genjutsu on him, making him do what he does later in this arc. And we didn't see much of his face, but I'm pretty sure that was Kashi and Koji. And if you don't read the manga, I would skip ahead a few 30 seconds to 45 seconds because I'm going to talk about them for a bit. So if that's really Kashi and Koji, then they revealed him way earlier. I'm not sure. I don't think I remember this scene being in the movie. But the fact that that could be Kashi and Koji, it's rather Kashi and Koji or Al. And I'm really leaning towards Kashi and Koji because he's the one who was wearing a hood. And he has the white beard. But I can't believe he really just made an appearance, if that was actually him. As a matter of fact, I'm pretty sure it's him because of all the connections with the Kara and things that are going on in the manga. And from the past few manga chapters, like, all signs point to this being him. So I wonder if he'll have any more appearances in this arc. I really can't wait to see, because after this arc is the arc that's in the manga. And I'm pretty sure no one was expecting this in this episode at all. But that aside, if you have to cover your ears or whatever, it's fine now, I guess. Maybe I'll edit some way for you guys who don't read the manga to watch. I don't know, maybe not though. I assume everybody reads the manga. Anyways, that aside, Sarada tells Boruto about taking the chunin exams, but he's not convinced. But then she convinces him, well, Mitsuki convinces him, and says he can impress Naruto, which works. Then it's time for Himawari's birthday party, and Himawari and Hinata come and get Boruto. I remember this scene from the movie. One scene in particular that they cut out is where Sarada mentions how she finally saw Boruto smile and look happy when it was Himawari's birthday, but they cut that out since I guess it wouldn't make sense with the continuity of the anime because we've seen Boruto happy plenty of times. Then we get to the birthday party, and I was stressed watching this because I knew what was going to happen. It was just a matter of when, but they did add some scenes, like when Naruto talks to Boruto about their promise. And then it happens, Naruto's shadow clone disappears and drops the cake. And then Boruto storms off, and it's just sad every time that Naruto couldn't make it to his little daughter's birthday party after making a promise to his son. So then Boruto storms upstairs, throws Naruto's jacket, and then the legendary doorbell rings. Probably the only time I've heard a doorbell in all of Naruto. So then Boruto runs downstairs thinking it's Naruto, and it's the legendary Sasuke. And Boruto tries to punch him, but Sasuke's like, nah, that doesn't work. And then Hinata talks to Sasuke for the first time ever in the entire series. I'm pretty sure. That includes filler. Like, what are they doing? Because we know Sasuke didn't come to their wedding. I don't think he's ever talked to Hinata at all once. This could be due to the fact that they're both quiet people. And the fact that Sasuke has probably only talked to members of Team 7 and a few others. And there we see Boruto and Sasuke's first legendary encounter. And Sasuke literally just came. He's like, where's Naruto? Hinata, he's not here. Okay, bye. So, and Boruto just looks away at Sasuke in awe, and the episode ends. So, this was a pretty enjoyable episode, despite knowing what was going to happen. I really liked the things that they added to improve the story. My favorite, by far, has to be Tonari's meeting with the other Otsutsuki clan member on the moon. And even the thing with Kashi and Koji appearing, I thought that was pretty cool, too. And Boruto finally meeting Sasuke. I noticed that they did make an effort to improve the animation, but it's going to be impossible to get it to the movie level on a weekly anime series. Like, they just can't do that. So I hope no one really complains about that. But those were my thoughts on this week's episode. I want to know what you guys think of the movie readaptation so far. I think it's going pretty well so far. But thanks for watching, and be sure to subscribe and like and share if you enjoyed. All that stuff if you want to, and have a great day or night. Bye.